YouTube. Hello, friends and people in virtual world. Welcome back to Baggies TMD. Don't forget, guys, to hit subscribe and smash that like button if you're enjoying the video. Right, guys, we have the Oxford Rail Warwell. We have the Cav Alex Trains View Warflat, which is the better modern image MOD wagon. We're about to find out, guys. So, yeah, let's say we have the Oxford and we have the Cav Alex. Which one of these is going to be the better model? Starting off with prices, the Oxford Warwell I've picked up for just shy of 30 quid. The Cav Alex models Warflat, which is exclusive to Trains View, so you can only buy it through them, is £35 a piece. So already the Cav Alex is £5 more expensive than the Oxford. The Oxford is available at anywhere that sells Oxford Rail stuff. Cav Alex 1 is only available from Trains For You. Let's take them out of the boxes, guys, and let's take a look, a closer look at them side by side. What'll be interesting, this one, guys. Bit somewhat different. This is just a little comparison between two items. I know one's a Warwell and one's a Warflat, but it's still interesting to see which is the better model. So there is the Warwell. Let's just get the old Warflat out. There we go. So we've got Warwell and we have a Warflat. Pop the boxes out of the way. So yeah, overall, Warflat, Warwell. Size-wise, roughly the same, buffer to buffer. The Warwell is slightly longer, as I believe it is in real life as well. Going on a bit of a weight comparison between the pair, literally just picking them up and holding them, the Cav Alex Warwell is significantly heavier than the Oxford Warwell. Can't see this derailing very easy. That may derail if you've got a very long train. It's very, very light indeed. Rolling test. They both roll quite well, actually. They do. Both have got decent roll, so not very much rolling resistance in them at all. Now, let us bring you down a little bit closer. Oops, sorry if it's a little bit shaky there. We are on the selfie stick because we are technical here at Baggies TMD. So, just looking at the bogies on both of these. Obviously, we've got the Warwell on the left and the Warflat on the right. Bogey-wise, Oxfords have painted the springs on their bogies. The Cav Alex isn't. Both have very good detailing, lettering. All the little graphics are very good. Now, the Warwell has just got box standard wheels on it, slightly darkened, so more black, whereas the Cav Alex Warwell has not suspension, what are we on about, brake disc. You can just see the brake disc there, guys. You just see it, the grey in there, both sides, front and back of the wheels. So we have actually got some details there on the actual wheels themselves, on the Cav Alex one. But I say the Oxford one has had its springs painted. Like I've said before, no sprung buffers on the Oxford. Cav Alex does have sprung buffers, which is quite nice to see there. What else can we see, guys? Oh, excuse me, just had a quick drink of some blood orange cider. Very nice from Thatcher's. We're not sponsored by them. Paint wise, the Cav Alex Warflat is a much glossier look, more of a satin green. Green's a bit more vibrant than the Oxford Warwell, where the green is a little bit dull, like an olive drab, so it's very dull on that. Just going back to the bogies though, guys, I just noticed these ones have been painted black. These ones are green. I will have to do some research just to double check that that's actually how they are on them. We have chains on the Oxford. No change on the Cavalex, but we do have a lot of hooks for tie down hooks on this model. Looking at, oops, just chucking it around. Underneath, looking at the details underneath, guys, we have tanks on both of them, but the Cavalex ones does look a little bit more finer, and there's a little bit more paintwork going on there on the war flap themselves. Much chunkier bogey as well on the war flap. Much more of a sturdy model. Obviously, we've got the yellow bits painted on here with the white handrails. The little white handrails are all painted. Both of them are actually painted white as well, guys. Yeah, like I say, a little bit of a comparison there between the Cavalex and the Oxford Modern Image MOD wagons. Which one do I prefer, guys? Personally, I prefer the Cavalex one. It just looks a lot nicer. Looking at the Oxford one, it looks a little bit toyish, whereas the Cavalex one is looking a lot more realistic, just from the paint job, the weight of it as well. There's some serious weight in the Cavalex. So I personally prefer the Warwell the war flat to the war well, but either way, they're still both cracking models. I need to get more of both so I can get a full MOD train. Like I say, £30 for the war well, £35 for the war flat, guys. I enjoyed that little comparison video, guys. I'll say a little bit different here at Baggies TMD. Don't forget, guys, to keep watching as we have a bit of a layout update coming shortly. I'll give you a little sneak peek, the Southern layout's been ripped up. I've lost my mojo with the Southern layout, but that is for another video. Hit that subscribe button for us, guys, and I'll see you later.